in these few verses. 1:30 in the morning. A dark corner of the tavern, hardly lighted by its single lamp. Just us two, hidden by the partition. The waiter's fallen asleep at the door, waiting for us to go home. There were no prying eyes. It was so late, and just as well. We'd lost all sense of caution, our clothes half open. It was July, and very hot. Hands on each other's bodies. The feel of naked flesh 26 years ago, I feel again as I recall that night. Now, the memories enshrined in these few verses, this plain reliquary. Imenos. Profoundly sought and treasured when found, if ever, that morbid pleasure living on corruption, which seeks to measure against its own depraved intention another's depravity. With an intensity the fit and sane can never know. Who wrote this? None other than that young Imenos, son of a princely father and mother, bright sprig from a patrician tree. Imenos, notorious for debauchery in Syracuse, in Sicily, in the bad old days of Michael the Third, drunken emperor of revelry. On the ship. In my hands, a little pencil drawing, showing him that bright blue afternoon upon the Ionian Sea. Magical afternoon, the ship's deck hot, the blue islands as background for his intenser beauty. The drawing brings him partially back, but there's a lack remembrance only fills. More wonderful than islands, sky, or hills, his memorable features. He was sensitive beyond the bearable. That showed upon his face. So far as able, I resurrect that suffering expression that made the commonplace of all men's faces a thing of passion, and drew him out beyond the reach of time. Beyond the reach of time? For all these things, the drawing and the ship, that afternoon, are very old, like me. But full of mystery.